Is this kind of emotional for you, knowing that this is going to be your last trip to Sioux Falls? Are you sort of taking in all the sights and sounds and whatnot?
Yeah, for sure. I think it's, kind of surreal to think about that this is the time for me where it's finally my last time around going to the tournament. And so, I'm just excited for the opportunity. I'm excited for our team. And yeah, like you said, I just really want to take it all in, enjoy it, and just compete really hard.
Can you talk a little bit about what it's been like being the only senior this year?
Yeah, I guess it's, been a little different than I think what we all expected for our team this year, but it's been a challenge and it's been really fun. I think I've gotten to take on that leadership role for us this year, be a more vocal leader as, someone who's just been around a while at this point. And, I think I've been able to grow a lot in that. And then my teammates have also helped me get to this point too of being a good senior leader for us. And, I think that's kind of paid off throughout our season and hopefully continues into the tournament too.
When you look at your career, your statistics, your role on the team over the course of the last 5 years, it's been very similar. The numbers are the same. Your role has been very similar. What's it been like, kind of, being in that role where you're just asked to do the same thing all the time? And how have you approached that, knowing that, you've never necessarily been the star of the team, but you've always been, one of the most important players on the team?
Yeah, I think I've just kind of embraced that role that I've been given, just to be that kind of consistent, steady presence, whether it's scoring, rebounding, defending, kind of whatever we need that game, I'm just kind of willing to do. And I think on the different teams I've been on, that's worked out really well for us. I've played with some really amazing, really talented players, and I've been, just happy to be that consistent presence for us. And so, yeah, I've really enjoyed my role these past 5 years. I'm glad to kind of be that glue player for us. So yeah, it's been a good experience.
Has this year been more satisfying because of the adversity that you guys have faced?
Yeah, I don't know if more satisfying is, I guess, the right word, but it's definitely been re really rewarding to see what we've gone through just with the injuries we've dealt with, the adversity we've faced. It's pretty substantial this year compared to even some other years where we've had some significant injuries. But I'm just really proud of our team for just sticking together through all those injuries, all that adversity. It seems that whenever something else goes wrong, we just find a way to, stick together even more and keep moving forward. So, yeah, definitely a rewarding season. And I'm really just proud of our team for our fight.
Thanks, Tori.
Thank you.
Does anyone else have any questions for Tori?
I
Andrew,
do.
go for it. Yep, go for it.
Tori, you guys are going to be the favorite down in Sioux Falls. You've been in this position before in your career. How do you guys as a team handle those expectations and kind of handle the atmosphere down there in Sioux Falls?
Yeah, I think, we've kind of had to handle those expectations a lot. And so I think some of our leaders, I think, I've been in that situation a lot. We have some other players who've had those expectations on them in the tournament. And so I think it'll be really good to have some of that experience down there. And then I think just really focusing on one game at a time. Obviously our end goal is to win a championship, but we have to win 3 games to get there. And so I think just taking our time, focusing on one game at a time. There's always a lot of nerves. So just really taking it all in, settling in, and just letting the game come to us more than forcing anything.
Heading into the season, we talked about how some girls were going to have to step up in new roles. What's it been like for you watching girls like Paige and Brooklyn and Madison Mathewitz kind of, take on these new roles and really step up this year?
Yeah, it's been so exciting to watch them and so happy to see all the success that those players are having. And, like you talked about, I think we knew early on in the year when we were facing these injuries that we would have to have a lot of people step up and, fill roles that they haven't really been in before. But I think I've said a lot this year that all those players have been capable for a really long time, and they're kind of just waiting for the right moment or the right opportunity to come into those roles. And so it's been really exciting to see those players, play so well. And, I'm so blessed to be their teammates and play alongside them. And I'm excited to continue to watch them grow even when I'm done here too.
What is your confidence level right now as you guys are heading into the tournament? You guys have been playing really well, obviously, but it seems like you guys have kind of taken it to another level here this last month or so.
Yeah, you know, for sure. We've really been just working hard in practice every day, not taking any days for granted, you know, as the season's coming a little closer to the end here. So I think, you know, we're playing with some confidence. We ended the season kind of the way that we wanted to, so now we're excited for the tournament coming up. And, you know, we got a big week ahead of us just to prepare for that. And, you know, we're going to take every day that we can to do the best we can in practice to be prepared well for this weekend.
Specifically, offensively, what do you think you guys have been doing well that has resulted in, you know, kind of these explosive numbers for you guys?
I think individually just comes to playing with confidence and trusting each other. And I think we've been doing a really good job of just sharing the basketball. And everyone's just, you know, when they have that open shot, they're ready to take it or to make that extra pass. So
you had to take on a bigger role this season. Was there a conversation with AJ about that, you know, coming into the year? Or was it just kind of, you know, expected that you were going to have to step up with the injuries?
Yeah, I think, you know, too, just being an upperclassman, that leadership role was kind of there for me this year. And whether that be on the court or off the court, I think, yeah, I just kind of had to grow in that leadership role to kind of lead the team in a bunch of different ways.
Thanks, Paige.
Jim, you can go next.
Paige, how do you guys handle being such overwhelming favorites? You know, people are kind of saying, well, it's a foregone conclusion that these guys are going to win. No one's beat them in 3 years or whatever it is. How do you handle that?
You know, we know that any team that we play, they're going to give us their best basketball. So we know every game we have to give that same thing. We have to play our best basketball. So not overlooking anyone and just being ready and preparing each day and to put ourselves in the best position that we can each game.
It seems like over the years, the women's team in particular has done a really good job of playing to the crowd, of using that sort of home court advantage to your advantage. Do you guys talk about that? How are you able to sort of feed off the crowd as well as you are? Because that's a tense situation that could create pressure.
Yeah, you know, for sure. We get a great crowd in Sioux Falls, and it's a lot of fun to see a lot of blue out there. And, you know, yeah, that energy definitely lifts us up as a team and kind of gets us going sometimes when we need it. So, yeah, we really appreciate all the support that we always get throughout this tournament.
Tori's the only senior on this team. Can you talk a little bit about what she's meant to this team, not just this year, but over the years, both on the court, her consistency, and then obviously this year, you know, her leadership as that only senior?
Yeah, for sure. You know, I've had an opportunity to play with her for 3 years now, so I'm just really grateful for those opportunities. She's been such a great leader on and off the court, just kind of always been that calm presence for us out there and just always, you know, willing to make those extra plays. And yeah, she's just, yeah, a vocal leader out there and leads by example too.
Thanks, Paige.
Anya, what questions do you have?
Hey, Paige, I just had probably like two questions. What can you tell me about the fact that, you know, your coach said that you are another target on the perimeter? So how have you adjusted to being such a target? Because I seen when you were playing UND that, you know, they were putting pressure on you and you bounced back. So can you talk to me about that?
Yeah, for sure. You know, the coaches just have a lot of confidence in me to do a lot of different things out on the court. And I think, yeah, just they've helped me expand my game, whether it be driving or shooting it from the perimeter. So I think just being able to kind of adjust to what the defense has been giving us and kind of see how they're playing us throughout the game and adjust that way.
And piggybacking off of Tori Nelson being a leader for this team and what she's meant, what can you say has been some of the things that you've learned from her to grow as a leader in your role?
I think that just like all the hard work that it takes over the years to kind of be where she is today. Like I said, she just kind of leads by example and has always been that calm presence for us out there when we need it, maybe when things aren't going as well. Like, she's just always there to pick everyone up and kind of get us through those little maybe rough patches or whatever. So I think just being able to kind of have that calm presence out there that we can all kind of lean on when we need it.
My last question is, can you talk to me about the recovery process that you guys got going on this upcoming bye and what it means to, not know your opponent yet and how you guys are going to stick to the fundamentals?
Yeah, you know, for sure. This week is still a big week for us, not knowing who we'll prepare for yet. We'll still kind of, get what we need to get done in practice and work on the fundamentals and kind of put us in the best position that we can to play well on Saturday.
How are you guys approaching this tournament, just as far as knowing what heavy favorites you are, the long winning streak that you're going? How do you stay focused after a season like the one you guys have had?
Yeah, I feel like having a good regular season, that gives you a lot of good confidence going into the tournament, obviously. And I feel like this week in practice, our focus is to just work on the things that we can get better at and just not get complacent and not get content with what we've already done. So,
what are the things you can get better at?
We're really working on our defense this week and trying to make sure that that's going for us, because come tournament time, sometimes shots don't fall, and that's okay as long as you have your defense to fall back on.
I might ask you about it the other night, but I'll ask you again. What can you say about what Tori's brought to this team this year, just as the only senior, and especially in a season where you guys have dealt with as much adversity as you have?
Tori's been amazing. I mean, she's in a really tough position being the only senior, and with all of the adversity and all the things that we've gone through this year, I think she's just really led us in just how she responds to that, how she conducts herself, and I think we're all super duper lucky to have her on the team, and whether it's on the court, whether it's off the court, she's just been a really solid leader for all of us.
Thanks, Brooklyn. Good luck.
Thank you.
Andrew, what do you got?
Hey, Brooklyn. This will be your second trip to Sioux Falls in your career. What was that experience like last year? And how can you build off that from last year?
Yeah, last year was super fun. I feel like we made a lot of good memories, and I feel like we all kind of still have that taste of what winning the conference tournament feels like, and so I feel like we're all kind of hungry for that again and hoping to keep it going.
You've been seeing quite a few more double teams as the season has progressed here. AJ has talked a lot about your passing skills. Is that something that you've had to improve on, or is it something that you've always had and you just haven't needed to use it until later on in the season this year?
I feel like I've definitely had to work on that. I think the completing the pass part maybe isn't the biggest part. It's just keeping your composure, I feel like, when that happens. And I'm super lucky to have a lot of really good players around me that I can find, and they know where to get the ball, and I know where to get the ball from them. And so I feel like that has made it so much easier just to know where they are and they know where I'm going to be.
Thanks, Brooklyn.
Thank you.
Anya, do you have any questions?
Just one. Piggybacking off of what you said that you guys needed to work on, being as though that you don't know your opponent, but you have faced everyone at least twice this season, are there certain things that certain teams have on you that you need to work on as well?
I think just overall, we'll make a couple tweaks. We'll make a couple little minor adjustments to our offense and things like that. But I think just keeping it simple and just if it's not broke, like not trying to fix it. So I feel like that's what we've been doing this week. And then I also feel like really our defense is just our main focus going forward.
And can you speak about just the recovery? Because I know that with you guys having this bye week, it's a good chance to just recover over the season and then get back into it.
Yeah, this week off is super huge, and we're gonna use it to our advantage. And I think having Sunday off is also a super good advantage for us. So that's definitely an emphasis for our team this week.